Hey guys, if you are looking for a way to step up your brunch game, then you need to make these lemon ricotta pancakes.
The natural flavor of the lemon and the thickness of the ricotta cheese give these pancakes a slight tangy bite. It melts in your mouth, so soft and fluffy, absolutely delicious.
I did promise my kids these lemon ricotta pancakes for lunchtime, so it's a good thing they're easy to make. Let's go ahead and get started.
Our ingredient list is simple. 1.5 cups all-purpose flour, 3 tablespoons of sugar, 1 tablespoon baking powder, plus 1/4 teaspoon salt, 1 cup whole milk, 3/4 cup of ricotta cheese, 2 large eggs, 1.5 teaspoons of pure vanilla extract, 1 lemon. We are going to zest him and juice him. Also, we need 2 tablespoons unsalted butter. This is our ingredients. Let's do this. In a very large mixing bowl, crack both of your room temperature eggs. The great thing about this recipe, you can mix it all together in one bowl. Add your whole milk. I put our milk in the microwave for 30 seconds just to warm it up a bit. Next, we will be adding in all of our pure vanilla extract. Also, zest in that lemon skin. This is very important to the lemon flavor. I highly recommend zesting all of it. Pour in all of your fresh lemon juice, add your ricotta cheese, and also the butter, which we melted and it cooled off a little bit. Whisk this combination together really well. You want everything homogeneous. It's important the eggs get well blended. Now we will be adding all of our sugar and we're going to whisk this together again, making sure everything is completely combined and happy together. Take a large fine mesh sieve, place it over your bowl, pour in all of your flour, add your baking powder and salt, sift this in. This guarantees a good rise on your pancakes. It ensures they're going to be fluffy. Using your whisk, stir this together until it just comes together. You don't want to overstir. We want soft pancakes, not rocks. I also took the time to scrape the bottom of the bowl. I didn't want anything left over and sticking there. Your batter is going to be very thick. That's normal. Let's make some pancakes. Preheat your griddle to 350 degrees. Once it's hot, spray it down with canola oil cooking spray. I love it when all of my pancakes are uniform in size, so I'm using a 1/2 cup measurement tool to measure out my pancakes very carefully. Be careful not to overcrowd your griddle. You want enough room to be able to flip your pancake without sweating. Let them cook for 3 minutes on the first side, and then when they're looking dry around the edges and little bubbles are forming around the edges, that's when you know they're ready to be flipped. The aroma of these pancakes when they were cooking was amazing. If they sold a lemon ricotta pancake candle, I would buy that in a heartbeat. So your pancakes are supposed to cook on the second side for 1 minute. The way that I test them to see if they're done, I lightly take my fingers, press on the top. If it springs back, that means they're done. Before you make the next round of pancakes, spray down your griddle with cooking spray and finish up the rest of your lemon ricotta pancakes. They all came out looking great and smelling amazing. This batch of pancake mix makes 10 medium-sized pancakes. I top them with some fresh raspberries, a generous dollop of whipped cream, and plenty of maple syrup. These are the perfect pancakes to make for a special get-together brunch with friends. They have such subtle flavors and they're so tender and soft. Guys, your friends will be so impressed. If you have leftovers of these yummy pancakes, which I doubt, store them in Ziploc bags in your refrigerator. Reheat them in the microwave with some butter. They will still taste just as good.
It smells like my house is a bakery right now, so I'm really excited to try these delicious looking pancakes. That ricotta cheese, you can definitely tell it enriches the pancakes. Just melts in your mouth. So delicious. Thanks so much for watching this episode. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe. I hope to see you guys in my next video.